And no pressure, but the PM has hinted Aussies could get an extra public holiday if the Matildas win the FIFA Women's World Cup. Ahead of the World Cup next month, Albo told the Daily Oz, a Matildas win will have premiers racing to give everyone the day off. While another public holiday has been mostly welcomed, some critics just aren't sold.
I don't think it's necessary.
I'm not against it. I'm not for it either.
Any day off I can have, I'll take it.
Yeah. King's holiday didn't mean too much to me, so something a little bit more Australian probably matters a bit more.
Obviously, it will be a lot more pressure added with everyone, I guess, wanting another public holiday.
Doesn't matter the result. We still love you.
Play hard and win it for us.
Let's go, girls. Let's do this.
What's more Oz than winning for a public holiday? I thought that originally, and then I went and did a little bit of research. Hang on. What? I started to do some research.
Well, Captain Liz Ellis.
I Googled, right? And so Australia doesn't have that much in the way of public holidays.
Really?
So we get 13 a year, give or take, depending on states. Yeah. Hong Kong gets 17.
17?
Nepal gets
35.
Wow. 35? I know. Sri Lanka get 25. Wow. We should have a public holiday for every Australian team that wins everything.
Or doesn't. Even when they don't win, let's just have a public holiday.
Well, when the Queen died, there was a day of mourning. Maybe if they don't win the World Cup, we get a day of mourning every year till the end of time.
That's a great idea. But look, if you are interested, the Matildas kick off their campaign against Northern Ireland on the 20th of July and pencil in Monday the 21st as a public holiday, 21st of August after they win. But, hey, let's have a public holiday after they win every game, not just the final.
Okay. We should also have Liz Ellis captaining the project.
Yeah, I hear